Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Jess. So yeah, I've made a video in about a week, but oh, it's been a crazy week. Like, I feel like, you know, this whole virus situation is really like changed up the way I thought this year was gonna be, and I feel like it's made me really shop more than usual as well. And I've really been trying to distract myself with like online shopping, and yeah, I think other people it's had the opposite effect. Like, they've kind of just really thought about like what they have, and like they can't go anywhere, so there's no point in buying a handbag. But for me, I feel like fashion is like an escape, so I always think about, you know, what to buy next. So yeah, anyway, you guys would have probably, oh, I don't know if you have seen, but on Instagram there was a few sneak peeks of the new Cruise 2021 collection for Louis Vuitton called Game On. So yeah, it's a pretty cool collection. I don't know if like any, well, actually I'm lying, there is one bag which looks really cool to me, but let me just, you know, go through my opinions on each bag. And yeah, I'd love to know what you guys think as well, because yeah, when I saw those sneak peeks, I was like, wow, this is gonna be popular. So the first bag I noticed, there was like a vanity PM, and it was in like a white kind of canvas with colored monogram. Now I've wrote some notes here. What did I say? Yeah, so I noticed there were two colorways. There was like a white colorway, and in the monogram there was like gray, blue, red, and black throughout, and little hearts in the monogram as well, which was like so cute, guys. Like the little hearts, oh. And on the clochette there's a little heart as well, which I just think is so adorable. And I did at first think, oh, are they just trying to reinterpret the multicolor from Takashi Murakami? But honestly, I don't know if they are purposely doing that. They kind of are just, I don't know, playing around with the colors again. And there's, oh yeah, there's also like a black colorway. And that black one has brown, red, white, and blue. So it is a little bit less colorful than, say, the multicolor, which, you know, has so many colors throughout it. Like there's green, blue, like different tones of blue as well. Like this one, there's a lot of different variations of color throughout, pastel. This collection, the multicolor kind of like monogram, is not really, I would say, multicolor. It's more just some core colors. Yeah, and yeah, it does look quite effective. I do think it will be popular. I personally am not going to buy anything from that sort of canvas, because I think it's going to be so expensive, just like the Escal collection. You know, from the Escal collection, I did get a few items. I ended up letting go of a few of my Escal pieces, and I've kept my mini pochette. Now, I really love this colour, and I think as a little collector's piece, it's nice to have. But I have a feeling that, you know, if I was going to buy, say, the Vanity PM in that super cute little heart white colourway, which I think is cute, it's probably going to be over 4,000 Australian dollars, because the normal one at the moment, I believe, is 3,600. So when something is limited edition, it will just amp up the price even more, and I don't know if that's going to be worth to me $4,000. Also, I feel like that colorway might be a little bit difficult to style. If it was, you know, under 2,000, it's nice to have some fun bags like that, but you know, as that is a big kind of chunk of money to put towards something that is quite, you know, daring. But I do love it. I do love that they did this. It really is really fun, and it's not super safe, but it's very novelty. Also, you can get the speedy bags in the same, there's a white, you know, kind of multi-coloured, it's not really multi-coloured, but like a white version and a black version canvas. And they also look like they're the speedy 30, which I really wish that they would have done a speedy 25, because I think this print would actually really suit a speedy 25. Also, you will notice on the sides of the bags there are like playing cards on the side, which I think looks kind of interesting actually. I think a lot of people thought that was kind of unnecessary, but it's kind of cool. And I do like how they've done the handles in like the black leather. I think that's quite practical and it will wear well. There are also brown versions, like brown monogram versions, and they have some kind of like prints on them, like some motifs of like playing cards, kind of inspired. This whole collection is like, you know, gambling playing card inspired, and yeah, it's I'm not sure what the purpose behind it is. I was reading on the website it was something to do with Nicolas Ghesquiere really looking deep inside and thinking about, like, you know, how he feels. And it's not, this collection is not necessarily about, you know, traveling, which, you know, usually cruise collections are about, you know, going overseas or going on a holiday. This is more about like looking inside yourself and thinking about how fashion is just like, you know, risky, and maybe it's like a metaphor for that. I'm not sure, but yeah, it's not really like a travel vibe like cruise collections usually are. It's, yeah, it's definitely like a, I don't know, it's almost like a mod kind of theme I see as well, especially in the colours. They're very strong. Anyway, let's go back to the bags. I was kind of rambling then. There is also a really cool bag that they've brought back. So it's called, I think, the LV Square bag. And this bag came out in 2018 in the reverse colorway. And they've brought it back in this really cool dice design. Like, this is actually really awesome. Like, it's a really cool design. I feel like on each, yeah, on each side of the, you know, the cube, they've done like a little dice kind of print. That is really cute. Like, it's probably like, yeah, the most novelty out of all the bags. Actually, no, I lied. I think the most novelty bag is, there's this bag and it's like just playing cards. I really don't think that's that cool, because it kind of reminds me of like Kate Spade or something. But it, yeah, I mean, it's interesting, but yeah, it's definitely, it doesn't look like Louis Vuitton. It's definitely more of like one of those fun brands, like, you know, Kate Spade even. Like, I feel like that's not really Louis Vuitton to do that. It's a bit too cheap, I think. But it's cute, none to, you know, but it's gonna be so expensive. It's just not worth it for that kind of novelty piece. But the dice bag is really cool. I mean, if I was rich, I'd probably think about getting that. But again, it's probably gonna be a little bit, you know, challenging to style, but a really cool collector's piece. There's also a Petit Mal, and I saw a black kind of version with, again, the little, like, you know, LVs and the little hearts. The little hearts are a really cute touch. I think they make all the bags look really sweet. And there's also going to be a few offers of the Dauphine bag. There's like a brown monogram version with a black trim, and in the black trim they've got little tiny hearts and spades and diamonds, and I like the little trim. I think that's very cute. But there'll also be a Dauphine in that same white colorway, and I think possibly the black colorway as well. And what else did I love? I mean, there's the Twist bag. Looks super cute. There's a white one, and I think there's also a blue one. The white one has like a triple heart, like pink hearts, with this little white top handle. That's a really sweet looking bag. I think that will be, yeah, that's probably one of my favorites. And there's also a blue colorway with like a little spade shape on it as well. Let me talk about my favorite bag of the collection. I feel like this will be a hit. It's a little monogram, a brown monogram heart shaped. It looks like the Boit Chapeau. I don't know if I'm saying that right. And yeah, it's heart shaped, so cute. So they've made something that's quite kind of, you know, ordinary, just the brown monogram, they've turned it into a heart shape. Like, it's a really cute interpretation, I think, of the Boit Chapeau. It's very novelty, it's very young, but I think that's gonna go off that one. I'm honestly considering pre-ordering that, if it's ever open to pre-order. but only if the price is reasonable, because like I was trying to figure out what price this would be, because the Boit Chapeau soup in the PM size is $2,720 Australian, and the Boit Chapeau soup in the normal size is $3,800. Now to me, this little heart looks more like the PM size, so the smaller size. So if I'm going to guess how much this is going to cost, I'm going to say $3,300 Australian. So I don't know if I'd be willing to pay that much for this kind of monogram bag, but you know, we'll see. I think this collection will be released end of year, maybe November or so. So I have some time to think about it. But yeah, this bag is adorable, and I have sold most of my Louis Vuitton monogram bags. I still have my Palm Springs Mini, which I love. Also the Boit Chapeau, this little heart bag, has a lot of vachetta on it, which I didn't say, I'm not a big fan of vachetta. Although I think it does look really cute in this design. I think the lighter leather contrast really elevates the little heart shape as well. It really borders it nicely, so it does work with this design. So yeah, tricky one. I might consider getting that one. There's also this really cute little charm I noticed. It's shaped like a spade. I saw it dangling off a petit mal, and I thought that was also really, really cute. And that would be so cute. Imagine that just like hanging off here, or like, oh, okay, I'm getting carried away now. Even I feel like the SLGs in this collection are just going to be so popular, like, oh. And I'm a sucker for SLGs. I've sold a lot of my SLGs because I know they really add up, and they do. You can get a lot of money if you sell them as well. I mean, you will probably lose some money too, but I mean, they add up, guys. So yeah, if you were saving for a bag, don't get distracted by the SLGs in this collection, because they're going to be hot items, and I don't know if they're going to be worth it. They might be a little bit overpriced. There's also a bag called I think it's the Danube bag. It's spelled D-A-N-U-B-E. And this is a pretty old style. I've seen them on eBay as well. You can snag one of these for a really good price, but they reinterpreted it in this collection with some little kind of motifs on it, and I think the strap is not like vachetta. I think that's a really cute and practical bag. You could definitely get the look for less on eBay, but you know, it's a really cute collector's piece, and it does have that little print on it as well. So I think that would be a really practical bag to get. This whole collection, I'm worried, will probably be super overpriced. But yeah, if I'm going to get something, it's probably going to be that heart bag. I'm still considering actually also getting the Petit Sac Plus. So yeah, I have been saying that I didn't really want to get that because of the vachetta leather handles. But I'm actually considering going for the Epi leather version, the pink one with the black handles. My friend has actually ordered it, and she's also ordered the monogram version. So I'm going to check hers out, see, you know, how she feels about it and everything, and I might be getting that later, because I have sold a lot of bags recently, and I think the little light pink bag will be super cute in my collection, because I don't have any light pink bags, and that could be just a little cute. And the price point is not bad, and it's all leather, so yeah, and I have a lot of Chanel now, so I think it's okay to have a few little, like, you know, pieces that are not over $4,000. I mean, come on. So yeah, I might get the little pink one, or maybe the heart bag. I don't know. I can't decide. Do you guys think this Game On collection is really overpriced? Are you thinking of getting anything from it? I'd love to know. And yeah, thanks for watching my video. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon. Bye!